morning, Standard 2. Children, today we are going to start our next topic, processing device. The last video we had started our third chapter, computer devices, and we had discussed about input devices. The devices which are used to give input, data and instructions. Okay, give data and instructions to the computer. Those devices are called input devices. So many input devices we have discussed, like scanner, microphone, keyboard, mouse, joystick, get, give, back, pad. We have discussed. Okay. Now today's topic is processing device. Okay. So processing device, CPU. Okay. Is a processing device. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. Okay. It's a brain of computer. Standard 1, you have learned about this. Brain. It's a brain of computer. Because you know, CPU does all the calculation. Understood? All calculation takes place in CPU. Understood? Calculation which we do through our brain, no? In our human body, brain. We have brain to do calculation. And in computer, CPU is there for calculation and to process data. Okay? CPU process data. Processes data. Okay. Here in the first chapter we had discussed about this working of computer. So second phase is processing, and processing is conducted by CPU. Okay, whichever data we give to the computer, suppose instruction we give to the computer, to add two numbers. Okay, so we give instruction to the computer through keyboard, but calculation takes place in CPU. Like this, 22 plus 45. If it is like this, if these two numbers have to be added one. So CPU will add these two numerical data. Okay, this is adding instruction. Okay, then result will be 67. This way, CPU calculates. It's a brain of computer. So this is a processing device. Its picture is given at page number 26. Here you can see it's a small chip, okay, small computer chip. This process data. Okay, it process data, whatever instruction we give to the computer. Okay, so CPU calculates. CPU solve the sums and gives us result. CPU gives result. It process data. It gives result. Understood? CPU gives result. So this is our processing device. Processing device now we have done. Next is output device. So there are many output devices. In your book it is given monitor, printer and speaker. Okay. Monitor, printer, speaker. These are output devices. Monitor. First we will discuss about monitor. So monitor is also called VD. Video its full form is visual display unit. Okay. letter is visual display unit, VDU. Okay. So you know about monitor. Monitor displays everything. Whatever work we do on computer, so it can be displayed on monitor. So that is why its name is visual display. Its name is visual display unit. Okay. So it shows output. It shows output which is generated through CPU. Output which is generated through CPU can be seen on monitor. Can be seen on monitor. Okay.
Excuse me.
Okay, students. So we were talking about monitor, visual display unit. Okay. So it shows output. Okay. Result which CPU calculates, no? So result we get through monitor. Okay. Monitor shows us all the output, all the result. Okay. Its name is visual display unit. So monitor shows output. That output can be a picture, can be text, can be video. So these things we can see on monitor. Picture, text, video. Okay. Now monitor. Okay. So what can we see on monitor? Pictures. Then text. Now, next output device is printer. Okay. So one more thing you have to learn. Output which is we see on monitor, no? It is called soft copy output. It is called soft copy output. Okay. Now printer. Printer gives us output. Which output? Only text and picture. Video cannot be seen on paper, no? Because printer gives output on paper. Printer gives output on paper. Okay. So printed paper. Printed paper is called hard copy. It's called hard copy output. Hard copy. So there are two types of output. Output which we see on monitor, it is called soft copy. And the output which we see on paper, which we get in printer, no? So that is called hard copy output. Understood? So printer gives us output of paper. So whatever CPU has generated, result, so that result can be seen on paper through paper. Then next is, okay, now there are three main types of printer. Three types of printer. Okay. Three types of printer are, first one, dot matrix printer. Dot matrix printer. Okay, it's a very old printer nowadays. People don't use this one because it is very noisy and very slow printer, okay? So, nowadays we don't use this dot matrix printer. Okay. Too much noisy and very slow printer. So, dot matrix. Next is inkjet printer. Inkjet printer is, it is very good printer. Generally people use it. At home. Okay, generally we keep this printer at home. Okay. Not noisy, gives very good output and fast. Okay. Print it gives very fast. If we compare it with the dot matrix, no, so it gives very fast printing and it is very cheap also. Doesn't cost much. Okay. So inkjet printer. Very popular among people. So inkjet printer. Next is laser printer. Next is laser printer. Laser printer quality is very good, okay. It is very good quality output of paper, okay. Print you get through laser printer, no? So that printing is of very good quality, high definition quality you can say. Okay. So best one among these three, no? Laser is the best one. Laser printer. So three types of printer are there. Automatic, inkjet, and then laser printer. Next output device we will talk about is speaker. Okay, speaker. Speaker, all of you are familiar with this. Speaker and headphone. Headphone. Both are used to listen music and sound from computer. Okay, listen music and so sound, music which are stored in computer can be heard, can be listened through speakers. Okay. Speaker gives loud sound. Speaker gives loud sound. Speaker gives loud sound. Which sound which can be heard everywhere, which can be heard by everyone. Understand? Are playing music through speaker, no? Everyone can listen. Next is headphone. Headphone, you know about headphone, you wear it on head. So, in case of headphone, no, only person who is wearing headphone, that person only can hear. So, other people will not, does not get disturbed with the headphone. Understand? Headphone. Headphone we can listen music without disturbing others. Okay. So these are output devices. These two are used to listen music. Okay. Headphone and speaker. Both are used to listen music. Any sound which is stored in computer. So these are output all these output devices. Okay. Now next are storage devices. Now we will discuss about the storage devices. Storage devices. Storage devices stores data. Storage devices stores.